What is up? I'm Stacy and I'm crouching down because I don't really have a seat around here and I want you guys to be able to see me. I got a question on one of my videos. Have I said I'm Stacy already? I'm Stacy if you don't know who I am. Hi, welcome. Thank you for pressing play on this video. I got a question on my last video that I uploaded, or on a video that I uploaded. Oops, this is not what I wanted. Sorry. Hold on for a second there, I went on the wrong thing. So on my video called We're Doing Things to Make Them Happy, or maybe I changed it by now, I don't know, you know how YouTubers are. I got a question that says, I always ask myself why we do things to make them happy. I'm also happy seeing them happy, but when should I stop? By the way, thanks Stacy, I miss watching your videos. Love from the Philippines. Oh, thank you, love from California to the Philippines. I hope that you continue to watch my videos. My videos are always there for you to watch and catch up on and be up to date with. So please do. And as far as your question, I know what you're talking about because I am that kind of person too. Like, I like to do things for other people to make them happy, but I like making them happy. There's two things I think that separate that, is doing things to make others happy when you're not happy and just doing it for that specific reason, and doing things because you like doing them, because you like the genuine feeling of making other people happy. That sounds like it's very closely related, but if you think about it, you sit back and think about it, it's not, because one is being happy doing that, and another is being happy but also it not lasting very long because you're not really making yourself happy, you're making others happy, and you're only living in that moment for like a few seconds, a few minutes. I don't know, I think you should stop when you realize that it's not actually genuinely, truly 150 million percent making you happy. A lot of us do that, a lot of us do things because we don't want to, you know, feel the repercussion or feel the disappointment or just the fear that we have of those things because we're scared that somebody may be disappointed in us or be upset with us if we choose to do things a different way or things that wouldn't necessarily make them happy. But would make us happy. At that point, I think if you're actually, you'll know if you are doing things that are making others happy and they only make you happy for a little bit and then you feel very unhappy about it, or if just you like doing things that make others happy because you like it, but you realize that it's not making you happy at all, that's when you should stop. I think it's really great that you have that want and that desire to make others happy, but I think that it has no value to you if you continue to do that and yet you're not making yourself happy. It doesn't make you genuinely happy. I know seeing the ones that we love the most happy does make us happy, and I think that's great. And it is a good feeling seeing them that you love so much being super, super happy, especially when we are part of the reason why they're happy or why they may be feeling happy or why they get happy. You know what I mean? I think that you yourself know when is the good time to stop or when you should stop. And I can't specifically give you a formula or a day or time or when you should stop. I think it all has to come from within here, within your heart, within you, because you know my right from wrong will be absolutely different from your right from wrong and the next person's right from wrong and everybody else's right from wrong, possibly your parents' right from wrong, you know what I mean? So everybody has a different opinion, everybody has a different reasoning. So I think that we were all given our own bodies, our own minds, our own mental capacity to realize and to know what we feel is right from wrong, what we know is right from wrong, and it's up to you. It's, you know, you don't always have to listen to everybody and everybody else. You just listen to yourself, listen to your heart, and if you're unhappy for whatever reason after you do something, or you're, you know, you think that there's a way that you need to be feeling, don't listen to that. Sit back and realize that the way that you need to be feeling is the way that you want to be feeling, that makes you happy, that makes you feel good. Don't conform yourself to somebody else's liking. Hey Tiki. Or somebody else's wants or whatever. Don't live by anybody else's rules. Like, live by yours and be happy. I think that's what you need to do. Hi, he's so gorgeous. Like, Tiki lives by her own rules. I mean, she lives with mommy's rules, but she's a happy puppy. So yeah, I try to answer that to the best of my knowledge. Another thing that I kind of think of, oh, okay, Tiki noticed. She's like, Mom, what is that? I think that there's a moment in time where, like, if you ever hear, for example, if you hear some people with a lot of money realize that money really honestly doesn't buy happiness, and like, I would not be able to tell you that because I'm not rich, I'm not, well, I don't have loads and gobs of money, but I have heard people that say that you can have all the money in the world, but it's not gonna buy you happiness. It can buy you things that make you happy for a moment, or do things to help you feel better, or you know, you can buy your wants and your needs and all that, but all of that doesn't suffice, doesn't amount to true happiness and genuine happiness. So I don't know, I wouldn't be able to tell you if that's true, but I have heard a lot of stories, and at the end of the day, it only makes you happy for a certain amount of time. Same thing with people that bully. You ever wonder why the heck they have to bully so much over and over again? Is because, think about it, they feel good for that one moment, but once that person gets over it, it's already done. They have to go back for more because that's the only thing that makes them happy, because I think deep down inside, they're very miserable. What's important is that you need to do you, you need to make yourself happy. And if you like making and seeing other people happy and it genuinely makes you happy and you don't feel sad or upset or anything about it, go for it. Don't ever change your lifestyle, the way you are, who you are, to please others and to make others happy, because that's the way they would want to see you. I think you need to be who you are, and you need to be happy and accept yourself and all shapes and sizes and forms and whatever way that you can, you know, better yourself or whatever. And if anybody can't accept you for who you are 100%, that doesn't just mean gay, it doesn't just mean your sexuality, it means all around, for every little thing that makes you genuinely happy. If somebody can't unconditionally love you and support you and accept you, then just know that you don't have to live up to their expectations. Okay, love yourself, and if somebody can't love you, too bad, so sad, you know what I mean? Find people that, there are plenty of people out there that will, and there are plenty of people in your life that do. So yes, keep that in mind. Thank you so much for asking this question. I hope I answered it to my best of knowledge. And yeah, so thank you guys so much. You guys watching my videos, commenting, coming on live streams and all that makes me genuinely happy. So I just want to say thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for doing that, for supporting me, for loving me, and for being here. So thank you so much. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to follow me on all my social medias, please. And before I go, I just want you to remember one thing. No matter the highs and lows, always be sure, always be certain to do good, be grateful, and stay humble. See you guys in the next video.